peace stopped, where war begins for the new submarines that arrive at the rate of 4 and 5 a month. Fresh new crews, clean new boats are welcomed by the veterans into the camaraderie of arms. An emotion of men welded together in a common experience with a common purpose. Submarines Pacific, Admiral Lockwood. With more than 20 years' experience in submarine warfare, he remembers that underwater boats almost brought England to her knees in World War I. He has seen the havoc wrought by U-boats in the Battle of the Atlantic in World War II. If the Axis can do it, so can the Allies. From his headquarters in Pearl Harbor, the Admiral directs a powerful, coordinated force of Allied wolf packs and single submarines, ranging from the Aleutians to the East Indies, from the Societies to the Kuriles. All over, everywhere, underwater sailors execute the first commandment of United States submarine doctrine. Inflict maximum damage on enemy ships and shipping by offensive patrol at focal points. In from the submarines at sea pour the results. From Rasher, 100,000 tons, sunk. From Barb, 97,000 tons, sunk. From Tang, 94,000 tons, sunk. From Silver Sides, 90,000 tons, sunk. Gradual but incessant puncturing of the arteries, all over, everywhere, through which flows the life of the Japanese Empire. From headquarters go more submarines into war against the Empire of Japan. Clary's crushers, Roach's raiders, Blair's blasters. Preparing for the first patrol, submarine and crew face a grim gamut of missions. All hazardous, all alone, all far from base. They may be ordered to mine enemy coastal waters. They may be ordered to photograph island shorelines for invasion. They may be ordered to rescue downed pilots at sea. They may be ordered to smuggle spies into Japanese territory. They may be ordered on missions from which there is no return. Orders. Many orders will be issued, and all will receive the same simple response. Aye, aye, sir. But no matter what the mission, the threat of death at full fathom 5, of death in the depths, hovers over the submariners. And yet they put to sea with one thought only. Follow the motto of their sister ship, Gudgeon. The motto that says, find them, chase them, sink them. Japanese shipping is the immediate target of the Allied submarine offensive. The most modern, the most dynamic society in the East is an island society. And the Achilles heel of an island empire, the heartbeat of an industrial nation, is its means of transport over the seas. Destroy that means. Destroy the merchant marine. Destroy the Navy. And the skill and diligence of the 27 million Japanese who support the war will be valueless. Every shop, every factory, every industry will be idle, bankrupt. Cities of the East, Tokyo, Yokohama, Nagasaki, Kobe, Japan's foundries, steel mills, heavy industry make war possible. But torpedoes at sea will dampen the fires. ships for the fleet, guns for the army, bombs for the planes. Without the ore, the coal, the raw material shipped in from overseas, the furnaces will grow cold. The machinery will stop. Destroy Japan's ability to produce. That is what the submarines will do. Merely to exist in peacetime, Japan needs 3 million tons of shipping, the third largest merchant fleet in the world. For war, the tonnage must be doubled. To link the home islands with the essential resources of her empire, to maintain her garrisons overseas, to weld together the greater East Asia co-prosperity sphere, Japan needs ships. Ships and ships and more ships. Japan alive flows in through her ports, across her docks, and onto her wharves. The Japanese have conquered an empire stretching from Siberia to the Indies. But none of the victories won on the battlefield, won at sea, will profit Japan if the grubby routine of the waterfront is disrupted. No bands play for the vital Marus, the merchant ships. But sailing south, east, west, and north, they keep the island empire alive. Without her men of war, Japan cannot conquer. Without her merchantmen, she cannot survive. From the Asiatic mainland, from Malaya and Indochina, from the Philippines and Borneo, the plunder pours in that feeds the Japanese war machine, feeds Japan. Oil, rice, sugar, salt, the stuff of life itself. They sail, singly or in convoy, hugging the shore or far at sea. The freighters, the transports. Destruction of the Japanese merchant fleet becomes a major objective of the Allied war at sea. Top priority targets, the freighters, the transports. Chase 'em, sink 'em.